Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is Delicious, and this is the step two about what I wanna do. It's something like to make you able to create, to understand how you can tweak or whatever you want in the game. So, this is a preset. I don't even know what is that. It's a control possession 433. Diamo wide. Why I chose this one? Because lately I'm working on possession tactics that somehow are doing. I mean, I didn't expect they were doing. Could do decent, but not that really decent. We are going to check what happened if we create one starting from zero. So let's check what's gonna happen. Okay. First of all, we need to decide the mentality. Balanced, it's the most used for reason, because it's the one that is performing better. I mean, it's perform. For example, with Balanced, you will get 50 points. That's an example. With Cavicius, you will get 49. With Positive, you will get 48. Another example. What are the. But you have to understand this point. When you test with. You are freezing your player's condition and whatever. But when you are playing, I hope you are nodding because you are not doing that. Because if you are doing that, it's just you wasting time and you are not even. I mean, it's not even fun because you will win every game easily. Because you will not be affected by condition, morale, cohesion, whatever. But this is up to you. I mean, I am not stopping you from doing that. It's just I don't. It's senseless if you wanna enjoy the game or the simulator. So, mentality balanced, it's the most performing. So we will start with this kind of mentality. We wanna build what? A possession. I will not show you possession now. I will show you the basic. Again, press because for possession will be. I will make a full guide with the Zerbi recreation adaptation that I made. We know that from the test, the pass into space is it's a must to have for some reason because I really don't know if this is taking more risk or not, but I guess it is. Mixed crosses, I mean, final third, I was sure that it's. It's cosmetic, but for some reason low crosses are working tiny, 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 I mean 0.3 better. So we want final third. This tactical instruction, work ball into box, it's giving you minus one, minus two. You don't want that because you don't want to lose points. But if your players are not good to long shots, I mean, you have. Your wingers are bad to shoot from distance. Your central midfielder are bad to shoot from long distance. You can put work ball into box or you can use PI with shoot less often. It early crosses, it's good if you wanna build focus crosses for your lone strikers. So we will build something like that. And play for set pitches is something that I don't even know what he's doing, but I know that I mean it's giving you minus points, but it's good. It was good from the previous edition. Dribbling less and run at defense. I mean, dribble less. It's not something that you like on this match engine, but it's something that you like if you want to make a possession tactic. You can like it. Run at defense. It's something that you want because it's. Adding dribble more plus something higher than that, we don't really know what. But it's not, I mean, I am trying to explain you which are the TI that are providing you plus and not minus. Be more expressive is giving you minus because I really liked it on possession tactics because for me this is more about your mentality. For me, the players, I mean, if you are a restrictive manager or if you are a creative manager, For example, I really like be more expressive in the real football. For example, Spalletti, Sarri and De Zerbi. They say that the players should follow the tactical instruction till for example, in out of possession. But when we are in possession, they are free to do. I mean, if you see, I guess I am pretty sure see la point. They are free to do what they want. They are free to express themselves. That's what I mean. That's why you want creative players. Because if you put Totti and you say you can do nothing, just pass the ball. I mean, it's fine because Totti was really good at doing assist, but. You want even him to express himself. I mean, I don't know if you ever watched Totti, but there is one season with Cassano. They was only trying to shoot on a volley from outside of the box. They did like 20 goals like that. We lose the Scudetto for that reason because they were just doing this kind of volley and whatever. After someone came, say, if you do that again, I will cut your legs. So they stopped. Be more disciplined was good before, but now it seems totally cosmetic. So it's if you want to use it, it's really up to you. For this kind of tactic that I am going to build, I will not use it. The passing directness, the shorter seems to be the most effective. But I mean, much shorter. It's if you want to. I mean, you will lose like 1 point. But you will get more possession base. But do we care about for the kind of fortitude we are gonna build? No. Because I wanna build something that the ball will come to my lone striker. And the tempo is another thing that you means more about or you force. I mean, this is. The basic combination that every tactic have on this kind of match engine. But for example, I mean, if you play on tempo standard, you will see that if you go there, tempo will be set according to the team mentality. If it's balanced, I mean, usually it should say to you that it's example, if you go there like that, no, it's not saving. Don't mind that point. So we'll go. We want higher tempo because we want to play on gegenpress. In transition, counterpress. You can even. I am pretty sure that it's cosmetic. I didn't test the group. I will test it soon enough. But counter guys, it's like giving you three. Or 4 points, it's a lot, really a lot. That's you like it. Distribute quickly or slow pace down is something that you don't really care. I mean, I will just use counter for this tactic, just to give you an example of my tactical. I mean, what I mean with tactical power. The one that I like here, you can do even like that, or you can just do something like that. Roll it out, it's for example, it's the basic. I noticed this by planning. It's something that you like when you want to start from the players. I mean, instead of adding, I mean, if you see, I didn't even go there on play out defense. I mean, I will just, we will talk about that later. But if you want to start from this kind of from the defense, you need to put that because even though if you do take short kicks and you focus them, sometimes your JK will just do long shots. Why you don't want long shots? Because if you lose the ball, when you lose the ball, this is the problem is when you lose the ball. If you lose the ball and you are getting counter-attacked. You are gonna take risk and you don't want to take risk. You want to play the ball the most safely possible, at least on build up. But for this tactic, I will remove, I mean, I will let the counter press and distribute quickly out because If you check all my tactics, they are like that. But for me are most likely cosmetic. The purpose of this 43 is not something like you care about. And the out of possession, it's when, how you wanna interact with the game when you are out of possession. This is the trigger press. It's something that mean you can even go and if you want to play with opposition instruction that I don't know if I will talk about that on this video, but I will talk about even OI, opposition instruction, that is that. And for this I noticed that, I mean, you don't have a super trio, that is if you can use mid block when you don't have really, you won't really interact with the enemy build up till the first pass. This is more about you. I mean, the most used are it's Agent Press. I mean, no doubt about it. Or you can use mid block. In mid block, it's something that I like, for example, for away games, but this is a placebo. I mean, it's not something that I can tell you that Agar Press is providing you better results, but for example, I like mid block when I play. But this is me, and this is my placebo. I mean, it's not something that will change your life if you do something like that. It can change your life if you can't providing pressing on the opposition defenders. Like, I mean, you are facing Diaz. Diaz will not lose the ball versus your striker, so you can go mid block, so you will take some space for you, and you will gain. Maybe you will win for example, Diaz will pass the ball to Walker. Maybe you can win the ball when they pass the ball to Walker. Just examples. Ah, about the my defensive line. From test, much higher defensive line and much lower defensive line are the most performing. You can check whatever, I mean, for example, on my test league, much higher defensive line is providing 1 or 2 points. I mean, I'm not talking about 3,000 games. I am not talking about 6,000 games. I am talking about more than 36,000 games. I mean, the tactics, or maybe it's even more. I mean, this is just 10 runs. I mean, a lot of billions. I mean, we can even, I don't know if we reach 1 billion, but half billions for real, we reach it easily. For example, on my test league, much higher defensive line is the top. From FM Arena, much lower defensive line is the top. This is not something, I mean, why? Because maybe it's how I mean, FM Arena is built, I guess, 100% better than mine. But for example, maybe you will like to gain the space. I don't know, I mean, this is more about your defender. If you have fast defenders, I prefer to play like that. If I have slow defenders, I prefer, or if I am facing fast strikers on the other part of the game, aka your opponents, you prefer to play with much lower defensive line. Trigger press. Trigger. You can even go, I mean, for me, this is just, I mean, whatever you wanna do that, but for me, it's just much more often. Whatever you play possession or not, you want to gain the ball back. Tiki Taka, Guardiola, whatever you want. They have the 5 second rule that when you lose the ball, you want to gain it back. We can talk about whatever you want. Get stuck in. I will not use get stuck in for this tactic because I want to make you understand that get stuck in. Maybe now, I mean, from before the winter patch was like something better. No, for me it's cosmetic. I mean, you can do that. I mean, in the soccer, I mean, in the football, today modern football, you want your players to be aggressive. You can put here or you can put on player instruction. You want most of your roles to take harder, because you want to win the ball back and even to intimidate your opponents. Because if I am not doing aggressive tackles, I am not doing aggressive contrast, aggressive whatever, you will let your opponents do whatever they want, and you don't like it. No one like that. You want to control the game, whatever it's the system you choose, possession or counter press, whatever you like, you want to control the game. So step up more, for some reason it's giving you more goals. I really like it. Drop off more, it's a more cautious way. I mean, for me, they are both of them are. I mean, step up more, it's something that I like, and I want to run more games, and we will use step up more, but we are going to match higher defensive line for this kind of tactic that we are building together. Trap inside, trap outside, I don't know. I mean, to be honest, every time I try them, they are providing bad results, but for example, for me, they are totally useless. For example, I would even let them cross because it's noticeable that you really don't like to cross on this FM. I don't even know how the hell it's possible, but you don't like to cross. So, for example, you don't like this kind of mean. You will remove it because, or maybe hit early crosses. So. Can work? We are gonna find out. By the way, we are building a tactic from zero, preventing short GK distribution. It's evergreen, but I want to be sure that it's providing something. With mid block, you will not do that. You will do that if you are going to high press. You will press on the other side. I mean, whatever, you are like a wild dog that's going blah, 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 blah. So now we are gonna check the PI. Okay, so now we have to decide which roles do we want to play and why do we want to play them. I mean, so they are already double BPD, that it's a ball playing defender, but I mean, I prefer this kind of build. If you like to play with your central defender, I don't even know what's the point of that, but I am not gonna judge you. I mean, you are free to do whatever you want, but we are gonna play with a blame prone in defender. Since we are now, this is the point that I want to explain you. Since we are playing with get stuck in, I will not put any tackle harder. I put tackle harder on my test for another reason, but for example, we know that dribble more it's OP on the ball playing defender, and we are gonna put even shoot less often because we want them to do what they want, but not that much. So, ball more and shoot less often. You don't like them to stay on stay wider if you was asking me this question. For example, here we know that wingback or inverted wingback are the really the most OP. But since this kind of shape it's not really stable, we are gonna go to fullback. And on fullback we are gonna to choose head forward, sit narrower. Cut inside, dribble more, shoot less often, take more risk because it's a gegenpress, e cross less often, and we don't care about it. I mean, I saw that many players are making like one fullback on attack and one on One on support, I don't even know what's the matter if you play overlap or underlap, but this is up to you. I mean, you can even do that, but I don't like doing that. I mean, the purpose of that is to make like some. We push this side, but we have one winger on support. We support this winger, but it's totally senseless. At least for me, because we hit fullback on attack, whatever you want. I mean, the only one that it's not, you can put something like that. That's, I mean, this is a sense because your inverted wingback will go to inside, so you will build up a sort of 2-3 because the fullback will go like here. So in reality, will be 2-2. Depends on what we are gonna choose there, but we want them. I mean, we want the inverted big wing back to go there, the fullback to go here, because I guess he will go till the midfield, even so we can make this kind of shape that is from one side we go inside, and from another one we going outside. So something like that. So here we are gonna play from to play wide, and from one we are going to from the left side we are going to play inside. Halfback, it's something that you can play if you wanna play possession basic, but it's something that we don't really care about. I mean, we are gonna play roaming playmaker. We choose guard and move into channels. We are not gonna play with hold on position. Little often, dribble more. I'm putting just to make you understand that since we don't know which run a defense tactical instruction it's providing dribble more plus whatever which roles we are gonna put it just to be sure, not because it's necessary. So from the center midfielder we know that we have two options basically: central midfielder or mezzala, but we are gonna choose maybe. So here you can choose moving to channels from position, no cross left often, take more risk, shoot less often. Depends how good it's your players, and dribble more necessary, I guess. Here, so we have 1-2-3, we have one, we will have 1-2-3-4. We can play with four players on attack. So this is some kind of setup that I wanna test on FM Arena. So here we will play with we can even try a box-to-box midfielder. I mean, he got even only run from position, but I don't like it. That's why, I mean, seems that run from position it's good only on inverted wingback. So here we will, what do we want on PI here? We want to, since we don't have someone that is holding position, we can make also more. Okay, shoot less often. Okay, take more risk. This is something that I wanna test, but it's working in my head. I mean, we need four players that is gonna attacking. The inverted wingback. Inverted winger, sorry, I'm being dyslexic. Which I forgot to told you. I mean, we know that stay wider from inverted wingback it's better. So we are gonna make something like that. Shoot less often, no, take more risk, yes. Cross less often, something that I don't test. It seems I don't even make any changes. And cross from deep, if we want to use this, we can make it. So we can make it. If we want to choose to shoot, I mean, we can remove this thing. and we are gonna focus. That's why I let it stay. And we are gonna tell on player instruction, hey, you have to cross from deep. Most typical fullbacks, blah blah blah. To set up crossing opportunities from deeper areas on the pitch rather than wait until the ball is in the attacking third. So if he want to cross, he can do that from deep area. We will make another inverted wing back here. You can even make inverted forward. This is really about your players. It's up to you. I am trying to teach you how to make your. I mean, we can even make. Since he's cutting inside, here we are gonna make a winger. But he got cross more often, cross from behind. But we don't really care about maximum power. This is just an example that I want to give you. Fine. Here we want to focus. You can even play with the overlap. No, not overlap because we want to play underlap because we say that from this one. Ah, I forgot to put here. Dribble more, shot less often, take more. For the forward rules, it's mandatory. Okay, so we want to stretch. So like that, we are gonna stretch the field from the right. We are gonna cut inside from the left. You can even make the contrary. More logical, the contrary. Where is it? Winger here, better forward here, either. We are gonna test it. We are gonna check how the. I will make some simulation and I will test on my test league. I am totally making it live. It's a video, but I am making it live. So. Here wide, here inside, here he cut here inside, and he will go too wide to cross. About the our striker will be a target forward on attack, and we want move into channels mandatory for them because really good. You can even take more risk. I mean, if you don't like to play with pass into space, but for me, after the only rules that they are not affecting from taking more risk are those three triangle and the sweeper keeper will be and can be support because we want to focus on we can press. I mean, you don't need to add nothing. Maybe distribute quickly. Lower third, okay, it's fine. Like that, we are done now. I mean, we made. Tactical instruction, play instruction. We have a sort of tactic. We don't know how it's gonna work, if it's gonna work. And now we have to do the most the set pitches because we are gonna make from zero, or I will teach you how to make them on the next step. Okay, so I went before we go to set pitches. I went and decided to make a run of 3,600 games. That is at least a sort of where you can understand if you are going on the right direction or not. But since it was without my set pitches or the set pitches that I tested in depth and after I assembled. I went and tested it with my automated system. And we can see that there is a number, 39. This 39 is something that you will never like. It was better, it was 45, but so people asked me how without your set routine, tactic and score, 39. 39 is something that maybe it's more similar to the other content creator tactics, maybe. But I didn't put nothing here. I mean, we are going to in-game because I wanted to show you that we are starting with a 39 tactic. Okay, so my 39 tactics, now it's loaded. Now we have to understand when it's the right time to adapt the tactic to your players, or when it's not necessary, or if you want to force. When you force something, it means, it's really easy concept, it means that you don't care. I mean, you will let your Openda on target forward. That it's crazy because Openda it's like 177 centimeters. So if you are understanding, if you are following me in this one, you will just move this on advanced forward. You don't need, I mean, as I teach you now, you don't really need to put take larder because we have the get stuck in. If we want to go more in depth, I will even I will even teach you, but I will teach you on another video. It will be on for opposition instructions. So now I will simulate and we are gonna check what happened. Okay, so this is the simulation with a normal tactic, normal default everything, 433, blah blah blah. What do we notice it? 84 goal and 31 concede. Usually with the length, I mean, I guess we hit a super huge. I was expecting something like 75 maximum 80 or 70 or 75. Is what I'm just trying to explain you how the tactic power works and how the players power works, because players are really important. And lengths, I mean, obviously, even if they are predicted, because I really like people when they say, the team is predicted 20 and they have super, hyper, mega meta players, because yes, there is even meta players, but we are gonna talk about that in another video. So, average rate. As you see, my Openda, I mean, I just switched from target forward to advanced forward. Not because I think that target forward it was providing less performing, but it was to show you that you can change things, you can adapt, because it's kind of obviously that Openda can be a target forward. He will work for you in on speed, not on 8. So yes, you can change, you can adapt. I mean, even though I didn't even, I mean, for example, Cabot here, I could give another example. We could swap Cabot to Winger because, but the game it's providing you a sort of adaptation when they are playing. Sometimes he will cut inside, sometimes he will go to run on. Run with it, run wide, sorry. And now we are gonna check the stats, because this is the point where I want to bring you, because many people don't understand the power of set pieces. That yes, it's important, but it's not mandatory. So let's check it in detail. We haven't got a good average possess, but it's friends, guys. Don't I mean we will maybe ta, 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 okay, so attacking per games. this corner. Goes from the direct kick, we did goals from kick from free kicks, we did 3. Good number, yes. So wait, goals from corner, we did 2. But we don't know that if with because we didn't play with simulated, we don't know if with that kind of routine when we cross, if there is any ping pong ball effect that it's bouncing everywhere and you score. But 2 goals from corners is basically nothing. On defending, let's see how many. For example, this is a really, it was really really lucky in my, to be honest. But it's fine. I mean, it means that this corner routine can, even the default corner routine can provide you something, or maybe your players were too much good for the league. This is another thing. But whatever. This is a really good number. This is some. It's not that. This is perfect. 1-1-3. It's like you didn't even get a goals from. I mean, it's really fun. It can happen. This is good. So now I will show you with my set routine. I will just make a comparison so we can understand at least from simulation. And if you want, if this video will be, I mean, if people likes this kind of video, I will even teach you how to make your set pitches from zero. But now I will just make my assembling, and I will just make a 43 with my set routine, and we will check what's gonna happen. Okay, so I went and tried to make an optimization of the fast optimization of set routines from the custom clean sheet to check. I will even test on my test league to check if something gonna happen on our 39, but I didn't make them like I usually do. For example, here it's one of mine. I mean, I just meaning you can even make something like that. This is up to you. There are even I suggest you to check even Decadoni set routines, that it's really interesting on defensive, because they are providing you something more stable, maybe. But just because it was not necessary to incorporate them, not because they are not good, but because I said at a point it's gonna be most likely not impactful to change all the time your set routines. It will be impactful if you check in games that something is wrong. For example, many times I just use the set routines, I don't even pay attention, because my point is, I know that the set routines are really good, but I want to just to check if the combination of my rules are working. So I didn't even pay attention. Sometimes you can even, on some of my tactics, you will find something like that, that it's insane. You don't want that. You can just change it like I show you. I don't want to show you that. For example, here I kept the normal one, I mean the default one, I didn't change. I just, if you check, I put the DL here, DR here, I just put some kind of logic position. As you see, I mean, those defenders are, that's why I want, for example, DCL with left foot and the DCR with the right foot, because this thing will optimize your gameplay. It's not like they are giving you an advantage, but they are making your gameplay smoother. It's different. You can even play DCL with right foot. It's not like you're gonna lose 1%, 2%. For me, it's even about the gameplay. So I will show you really fast. I mean, you see, I just optimized their position. I didn't, because it's not even necessary to go there and be maniac. It's just if you check, it just makes some adaptation from the normal set routine. And thrown inside here, I didn't touch nothing, but you can even, for example, I will show you that from the Zerbi one. That's why I didn't even check it, I didn't even change the roles. I mean, this is default. I mean, I don't even know why, but this is default. I will kept it because for me it's not, this set routine it's the less important one. And from the corners on attack I made something different because maybe many of you say but the Lichus 35, 38, 100 goals on DCL. I mean, this is when you want to abuse something. If you want you do, or if you don't you won't do. For example, here is a simple 6 yard box that it's something that you will see in most likely on normal in real games that okay you are gonna try to focus someone but in you are just trying to send the ball to a certain area where you hope that you will score the goal. But guys, set pieces are important even in real games, not only on Football Manager. Okay, here we see something crazy like Diaz scoring 32 goals or whatever, blah blah blah. This is not real. I mean, this is when the game became a game, I mean, simulator became a game, and when a simulator is a simulator. This is a soft line that it's not easy, I do understand, but for me, the set pieces should be totally different so people can't abuse something like that. People like me that like to test and providing, I mean, before winter update, you could make a score like Zoma. You can check my screenshots there where Zoma did 50 goals one season. It's insane. I mean, I do understand that it's insane, but if you nerf the set pieces, you need to make to. Gave the players the right to develop their tactical powers. Because yes, players are really important, but even tactical power is important because you can check even in real, like, I mean, that's why I decided to make something adaptation or recreation, whatever you wanna call it, of the Zerbi. Because the Zerbi ball, it's something that it's, you can say that Brighton players are out of the world. They are good, but they are not like Manchester City players. You can compare them. So the tactical power, it's really important, but the players' power are important as well. I mean, you can't pretend to win Premier with 120 CA current ability players, not because it's impossible, but because it's not really logical that you think something like that, because it was happening on the previous edition of Football Manager doesn't mean that it's gonna happen on the future one, because they want to remove the abusing, and it's I really like this kind of direction that they want to make, but you should give us something that works if we make a tactical power works. So tactical powers should have a good wave like the players. But I know that it's hard to, I mean, it's really kind of discussion topic that it's take a lot of time. So now we are gonna check a simulation with a sort of optimization set pieces. Okay, then now we can see what happened with a strange corner set routine. The average rate is fine. I mean, you can see with your green eyes. Let's check what happened on the league. 89 points. It's not like when I say that you need to understand. That it's RNG, maybe it was really lucky, but I like the numbers. What I am interested in is about the goals that we went for and the goal that we conceded. 25 goal conceded, it's a really good number, that the number that you are looking for. So 89 points, competition with a new nothing, the data hub, let's check. I mean, we are really poor on scoring, on the scoring part, I guess. 1.97, but we considered really low. Maybe the RPM, the F, the fullbacks, something, it's not working, quite working. We really don't know, or maybe it's not because it's just without a good set routine on the corner, because guys, 25 goals, it's something that have another kind of weight. But you wanted, we wanted to check without without the set corner routine. You can see two goals from them, but we don't know how many ping pong ball effect we did. No, about that, I don't really, I mean, we did the three goals, blah blah blah, but this is something that it's that you don't even should care. What we care when we optimize the set routine, it's something that let's check from DFK, we considered zero. This is a good number, so we're gonna go there and see. Oh, what happened here? We got 0-0 before, it was 1-1-3, so we got something better than before. This is the way that I tested. I made like more than 100 simulation. I mean, it took me 5 minutes to make a simulation, so it's not a big deal now. But this is a really good number that we want. I mean, I made for this video just to make you understand that you can work on your set pitches. You can do whatever you want. This is not like, I mean, this thing, it's working, okay, fine. Maybe it's just the position that gave to the tactics some kind of power. So now I wanna check with the set routine that I made, not because I made, because I tried every option, and that's what gave me the best results. So we can understand the differences between a good corner set routine and with one bad one. So I will make it, and I will we will see in a few seconds. I mean, for you will be some second, for me will be like 2 minutes. Okay then, so I went and gave my corner set routine. I mean, just loaded it, didn't do nothing. But if you check, I did some changes. I made this red line, I mean, I call it the red line mistake, because I don't even know what's going on. I mean, this guy, it will go inside, will do something, whatever. The point that we have to understand is why we put this DM here. Because providing this DM here, you will remove one player from the box area. The IA will automatically go to mark him, because maybe the IA can't understand if you are going to make a short pass or you are gonna make a long shot or a near post. So this guy, this DM, will be marked from a player. So you remove someone from the box area. That is something that you like, because you are going to shoot, to take a long, I mean, from this one you are going to take a long one, so you like it, because maybe it was the higher one that could marking your DCR, and you should be take some good guy. I mean, this guy, it's a good meat of a piece of meat, because you see 190 centimeters, a good jumping reach, 17, guys, it's a lot. If you need some head takers, I mean, this is about the set routines. Which is important is who take and who receive the ball, because if we put Openda here, you will make him, you maybe will do 4 goals. But the focus strikers is something else. I mean, I like to focus my striker, because I build around a target forward usually when I play, because this is what I like to play, but it's not something that I can force to you. This is why this set routine, it's good, it's OP. But now we are gonna check what happened if we play these set routines. But what people didn't really understand till now, what happened if I have with much higher defensive line or with much lower D-line? With much lower defensive line, you will abuse the less possible the corner routine because you will build up in another way. And as you can see, there is even a step up more that I noticed now. By the way, now we are gonna check a simulation with a complete set routines so you can compare. And now, and after that, I will even make 10 runs. I will make it manually so it won't take me 1 hour and a half. So it can be a bit faster process. I promise you that I will not manipulate nothing, but it's just for the science, this kind of things, because people asked me the differences, and I build 3 different tactics, even if they are the same, but with different set pitches. So let's check what happened. So for the final simulation from this Lens story with a 4-3-3 random builded from me, not even random builded, but it was something that I wanted to show you, plus meta roles, plus something that we are thinking about, plus you did from ground zero, from copying set routines, or just optimizing the set routines default because it was a custom clean slate. I didn't load nothing. And so I will show you again because I guess I forgot to show the right one. This is the set routines that we used for it. You're gonna check what happened on the league. 96 points. This is a good number when you are testing. 96, 90, it's a good number. But what the difference is the goal that we scored, because thanks to the Lichus, we did more goals because we have a dance that did 18 goals alone more. But what is surprising me is this 24 concede. That is, this is a number that I like. And that's why it's important to optimizing, because usually I don't even care because 1.0 point, but it's something that you want to pay attention in your actual games. Because a test can be differences, the difference between 1 or 2 goals, it's nothing. But for you, when you are planning, there is something that you care about. On goals, if you see, for corners, we didn't even score that much, 12 goals. But it's a number. With the red line, maybe we did some good goals from the ping pong ball effect. But we don't really know because I simulated. So in order to understand this kind of things, you need to play. You need to analyze whatever is happening. And it's gonna be good. Or maybe not. Cross completion, if you check, 24%, guys, it's a lot. This is why this you will put cross less often. Because for some reason, you will not... they just cross when they are sure, but even the word it's kind of misleading sometimes. I mean, not sometimes, but quite a lot, because I am using it from the last from maybe you saw Bombite and stuff like that. I am really, and I found out more in deeply with the De Zerbi tactic. Cross complete, blah blah blah. We don't really care about those numbers. I mean, this is important, but not. For example, here now, what happened on concede? This time, you see, we conceded 3 from corners, 2 from DEFCON, EFK. This is RNG, but it's not really important. I mean, this is. If it's not 7, 10, 10, 10, 10, or 3, 2, 2, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, it's quite good. Because if the EA will not score you, you will just be super OP. But you can adapt to stuff when you actually play. You need to analyze. And I will make some runs so we can see the wave, the differences between the we started with a 39 tactics. We just changed the set pitches. I will make even some more adjustments to check if we can develop, but I don't think that I will do in this video. But this is a kind of formation that all of us love, and I want just to check you. It can work, but you need to understand how it works. And for example, I just show you that the basic tactics was from I will make I just decided in this moment that I will show you with Manchester City run, because I want to show you how can you adapt the tactic to the players. And so let's check what happened on the city that I just decided that I want to make. And after that, I will make 10 runs to show you the difference of numbers. Okay, for example, here, so you can understand in depth what I mean. Do we like Foden? We can like Foden. We can keep this winger here. No, I want Grealish. Where is Grealish? Here. But in reality, Grealish it's a right foot, so we want to change it. I want to show you this kind of process. So I want to. We can even remove this crossless often from. No, we're gonna keep it because we like it. Because, I mean, from the test, crossless often it's good on wingbacks. I just made with wingbacks. I just mean the position, not the role. So now we are inverted wing back here and inverted back here. This is fine. I don't want to change my CM roles scenario, but I want to change maybe here. I mean, Gomez, it's not really a good inverted wing back because. He's a good wingback. I mean, he's a god on crossing and corners. He will be 100%. He will be the most the one that will take the corners. But I want to change his roles. Just I mean, this is just an example that I want to make you understand that you can even adapt to your players. I mean, this is important. We want the cross less often, as I said before. The fullback here will be, but we want to create the inside the cut. We want play all at all. We are going on wide position, so the fullback will go at inside. It's narrower, important. And we can go back to the main point that it's a target forward. So Haaland, it's a perfect example. We're gonna check even this is the final one, so it's something that I want to just show you. This is a target forward. I am curious now what is gonna happen after the simulation. So just to show you that what I meant with so this is we can make a more reasoned concept. So I made some tweaks. I mean, target forward Haaland, and I swapped this inverted wingback because I wanted the Grealish instead of Foden. Something happened on the end, the wingback Gomez, because Gomez can play really a good inverted wingback. This is me, of course, obviously. So we made some changes, and maybe I didn't even it was even stupid because. Maybe Foden could provide a better performance than Grealish. We don't know. We maybe will not know because it's just one run thing. But this is more. I want to make you understand the concept of when you create your tactic. You need even analyze the players. This is really, 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 really important, and you need to understand it. So, for example, we came second, so something happened. 90 points. 90 points, it's acceptable. I don't like, I mean, with City, I prefer when we do more. But Liverpool did 94. I mean, guys, if you play the game, 94, 90, it's something that you will face. I never face it when I play something like that, but maybe this Liverpool, this Klopp was too much for us. 123 goals, it's a lot, and 29 conceded, it's okay, but it's not super, but if you see 24, 29, you can compare Premier League with League One, and I'm not saying that the tactic is OP, it's the last thing that I am saying. I'm just trying to explain to you. We did 21 goals from corners because Haaland is a monster. And let's check concede. I mean, maybe the problem was on concede. No, you see. So these set defensive set routines can work. I will test it. So the problem was the tactical power, the something from the tactics. It's not providing. It's providing something less. And in order to understand when you play, you need to understand how your players moving. And for me, it's something that you can tune without. Many tests you can understand. I mean, for example, cross less often from the inverted wingback, it's not something that you like. It's useless that I do another simulation. It's so just in order to make you understand that some of those PI that I put before, they are useless, they are not providing something. I mean, for example, we know that cross left often from the fullback, it's providing you something useful, something that it's because they will do cross when they can, and they will not just do random crosses without any logic. And maybe this central midfielder on support, it's not quite good because I wanted to, in order to support my RPM roaming from position, I wanted to make something that was providing some kind of support. I mean, even it's even wrong because I wanted to make something like that. But just to explain, I mean, this central midfielder did 22 goals. I mean, Gundogan it's a monster, okay, but De Bruyne is something else in the game. I mean, even really, De Bruyne, it's passed. So you need to, even this fullback was just for the, you can even play with double fullback and adapt if you want to get, if you want to move on, if you want them to cut inside or run wide with ball. You can understand when or where you, where you want to stretch the pitch. You want to stretch from right or from left. If you want, I mean, so many, for some reason, I don't know, you can even do something like that. Maybe for some people, maybe this is somehow, since you have overlap from left, you have underlap, you need to understand. If you put double overlap, the inverted wingback will wait the wingbacks who came to make an overlap. So it's already automatized. You don't really need to make attack here. You will just change something that you want. I mean, now it's not changing the mentality. But for example, It's providing cross from B-line, it's from default. And sometimes you don't want that. But you need to understand by planning how you can make your players performing better with your tactical, with your tactic. Maybe RMPM it's not quite good with this kind of tactical system. So maybe you can play, if you want to play, you can play ball winning midfielder, you can play defensive midfielder, that it's quite a god tire. You can play, because it's not gonna roam, maybe you want this position to be static. I will make some changes, but I will just test the this one. I mean the optimized the optimized one, so we can with a test rig we can check what is really happening between a tactic that provides us a 39 and one with set pitches optimized. This is what of the purpose of this video, not to make how you make your OP 43. You can make your 43 shining if you actually understand what you are doing. I heard a lot of things that simulation, not simulation. Guys, when you play should be easier than simulation. It's not should be harder, because it's supposed that you know what you are doing, not that you are giving everything to an assistant manager, EA, whatever you wanna call it. I mean, tactics can work, because if Alan, if you focus Alan, I mean, he should, if you focus Alan, if you make the tactic correct, Alan should score at least 100 goals, because Alan is a monster, it's a super coach, it's a super, I don't know, ball. Check the stats, it's insane. He did quite good, but maybe it could be better, because we didn't win nothing. I mean, we won a Carabao Cup and Community Shield. But we lost the quarter of final. We lost. I mean, we didn't really play. It should be maybe we missing four or five games. I mean, it's not even quite. But you need to understand where your tactical power were missing. This is why it's important, the tactical power, because if you are playing with a 40 power, tactical power, you somehow will miss something. And since the EA will face you in another way, I mean, for example, we are Manchester City playing versus Fulham. Fulham manager will usually play versus you on balanced, cautious way, will try to mark every player that is providing you after 10 games EA 100% will focus your RPM like no tomorrow, will focus your central midfielder, because if you see the most goals went from this central midfielder that it was like that before from Gundogan, so maybe De Bruyne could even provide more goals. For example, Silva did 21 goals and 25 assists. It's a lot, guys. It's not bad from the wingers. You need to understand where and when you can push. I really hope that you are following me. If you have questions, just ask them. Now I will make it. I guess this video will be mega long. I didn't check it. I mean, I am trying to provide from more. I don't like to make more cuts and stuff. I am just making a sort of a video explanation, video teaching, whatever you wanna call it. I will make those 10 runs with this 433 DM wide that we started from, and we'll see. We'll check if he can improve for that famous 39 points. So it will take a little bit more. So let's check what happened. So, 3,600 games versus 3,600 games, the differences was between the 433 custom preset, but with my kind of roles, it was 39 from set pitches, default set pitches, and with a sort of optimized set pitches, because I used some of them, but not of mine, not all of them, in a scenario where you are 140 CA team versus LA elite team, the difference was 5 points. For you, 5 points it's a lot, it's not. This is about you. it is something that you have to decide if it's something important or not. The tactic, basically, I mean, I didn't think about, I didn't want to make a super optimized tactic. It was just to give you an example from where you can, from we started from a point 39 and we came to 44 just by the set pieces. So means that we need to work something here. It's not working. I mean, it's obviously. And you need to understand, I mean, maybe it could be step up more. Most likely it's something like that. I mean, this is the next, I mean, you will see, I will make it your live, the one that I will present on, this is be my next step. No. Don't feel like that. Take more. I mean, dribble more. I am pretty sure that if you put run at defense, it's not necessary. Take more risk. I mean, we can let it because it's another thing that I want to explain to you. If you are sure, but not really sure. I mean, you are a 90% sure that passing to space, it's take more risk. Okay, follow me on this thing. Putting this take more risk here, it's not doing any malus to you, so you can't let it. I mean, just for the science, the RPM, I don't think so that it's working really good for this triple, I mean, DM and CM, because for something that I can't really understand, how the hell the central midfielder are more offensive than if, I mean, for example, if you play like that, for some reason you will be more stable on this kind of scenario that if you play on this in another scenario. So let's see what's going to happen, and I really hope you like this. I mean, this video took me a real lot of time because I wanted to show you the differences. If you play a good setup with your set pieces, you can even remove the... I mean, if you see... That's... Ah, sorry, I forgot it. This is the guy. In a test league... our super corner staker, because it was focused. Yes, was focused on him. He did 21 goals in 90 games. Means that this set routines, it's good, but you have to understand that you need to put in a kind of scenario, that this kind of scenario, I mean, on a test league, it's not really gonna give you 180 goals. It's gonna give you less, because maybe the opposition, the everything you wanna talk about, it's working in another way. It's not, for example, versus elite teams, maybe the static, corner set routine, it's good, but before it was really insane. You would have done like 41, 50 goals, and 30 goals, it's another number, it's not 21. 21 is something acceptable. You need to understand that you need to focus even the right guy. I mean, for example, if you have Haaland, you go to Haaland. If you have Luka, you go to Luka, because, for example, I love to see my striker to score many goals, even from corners, because they are divas. And if you have questions, do them. I will really glad to answer to every question you have, comments, whatever. And if you have some kind of request, this is I will try to make them. This is just a step, because after that I will release the Zerbi. I was about doubtfully if I should have released first my players But my list, I mean my top 5 for every roles players, I will do that, but maybe it's the Zerbi time, because now I just took an example about a 433 that can work and you can make it work, but you need to understand what is the ball that you wanna play. Because if you have 39, 44, 50, 100, if you don't enjoy to watch what you are playing, you will get bored and you will just try something else. Another thing that I wanna tell you, don't being so focused on the tactics, because it's totally wrong. It's not like the tactic will start to go bananas or go. It will. It's not work anymore. I heard everything. No. It means that when it's happened, it can be for more reason that I will not explain you now, but I will explain you later. And stay tuned and stay delicious, and bye bye guys, have a nice one.